One of the great gray areas of astrobiology is just how alien biochemistry might work. Conventional wisdom would be to look at life on Earth. We know for a fact it can exist. And then imagine how that might apply to life in the universe. And while there doesn't seem to be any reason to doubt that carbon-based biochemistry couldn't be common in the universe, it's also possible that other types of radically different biochemistry could exist. So here are 10 ways alien life could be radically different from that of Earth. Number 10. Alternative chirality. One odd aspect of life on planet Earth is that everything is apparently of one variety when it comes to chirality, effectively how biomolecules can exist in mirror configurations. But there doesn't appear to be any good reason why life couldn't also function in alternative chirality, and that examples of it just happen to be missing here on Earth. Or, at least appears to be missing, as amino acids of opposite chirality have been found here. And while they are thought to be a product of the decay of normal organisms, it also can't be ruled out that life of opposite chirality does indeed exist here and we simply haven't detected it yet. Given what we know, it could be possible that life on other worlds might be based on some configuration of alternate chirality. While different in a chemical sense, these types of configurations wouldn't be all that alien, at least in the sense of it being markedly different from what we see on Earth. In short, we would recognize it as life, but it would be alien in the sense that it would have no relation to life on this world, so far as we know. Number 9. Different solvents. We often discuss the search for life in the universe on the presence of liquid water on the surface of an exoplanet. There's a reason for this. It's crucial to life here on Earth. But our planet is a sampling of one. But water isn't the only liquid that life might use as a solvent, and we have to be careful of water bias when evaluating the possibilities for life. Perhaps the strongest alternative to water would be ammonia. Like water, there is no shortage of it in the universe. Ammonia can support a wide range of chemical reactions and can dissolve organics. Other possible alternatives to water include formamide, hydrogen fluoride, and even hydrocarbons, opening the way up for very low temperature life. And also liquid in low temperatures is nitrogen. But as with anything, there are trade-offs, and the alternate solvents seem more limited for life than liquid water. But water actually does have some disadvantages, one being that it has a very high albedo when frozen, contributing to the severity of Earth's ice ages. Also possible are a few possible mixes of water and other liquids, such as ammonia and water. This is thought to be possible at Saturn's moon Titan, where a subsurface mix of ammonia and water could remain liquid at much lower temperatures than water alone. The solvent in which alien life is based would also profoundly affect things like evolution. For example, water being transparent to sunlight helped guide the evolution of oceanic creatures, and ultimately the formation of eyes. In other conditions, in other fluids, the equations can change, and life based in an alternative solvent could end up being very different from that of Earth indeed. Number 8. Arsenic life. Even though arsenic is usually considered poisonous, at least to humans, it's thought that phosphorus and arsenic are chemically similar enough that it may be possible that alien life could use arsenic in its biochemistry and even its DNA. And arsenic might figure prominently as far as life in the universe at large, because phosphorus has somewhat of a problem. Astronomers studying the abundance of phosphorus in the universe have found that it's actually not that common, due to differences in how it's created in supernovas. If this is the case, life, at least as we know it on Earth, wouldn't be able to get started in some areas of the universe just from a lack of phosphorus. This is enough of a problem that the idea of phosphorus simply being rare and unevenly distributed in the galaxy could be a solution to the Fermi paradox. While contentious, if arsenic can indeed function similarly to phosphorus in biochemistry, then there may well be more arsenic-based life out there than phosphorus-based life. Number 7. Nongreen photosynthesis. Plant life on Earth is predominantly green in color due to the plant's inability to absorb some of the green wavelengths of light. Yet, the sun emits strongly in green light. Rather, plants tend to absorb red and blue light. It could be that green isn't absorbed simply because the plant has all the light it needs, at least those on land. But when you start looking at the classes of stars that might also be suitable for alien life, the profiles of their light emissions change. As a result, photosynthesizing plant analogs on exoplanets may not tend towards green, rather yellow, red, or even black. It's also possible that alien photosynthesizing analogs might not even be based on chlorophyll, but rather retinol. If so, this kind of life would appear purple. Number 6. azotosomes. It's possible, perhaps even likely, that the very simplest microbial forms of life in the universe will tend to look a lot alike, no matter where it's found. Some very likely will be similar to organisms present on Earth, but looks can be deceiving. If functionally similar, their biochemistry could be radically different. Take Titan, the only other body in the solar system to sport large amounts of liquids on its surface, other than Earth, that could support some kind of biology. The problem being, Titan also happens to be extremely cold, far colder than anything life on Earth can withstand. But what of a different configuration of microbial life? Researchers envisioned what this might look like by thinking about different kinds of chemistry, in this case, nitrogen compounds that could be used to create a kind of cell membrane that could function on Titan. Called an azotosome, this hypothetical cell membrane could function at temperatures where methane is liquid, about 292 degrees below Fahrenheit. Such a microbe could use the nitrogen, carbon, and hydrogen that are present on Titan in its biology and use no oxygen at all. Number 5. The Long Sleep. With planet Earth, we essentially got lucky as far as stable climate conditions. Mostly. Our planet undergoes seasonal changes that make certain periods harder on some animal life than the rest of the year. But this could actually get much worse on exoplanets, where life, at least as we envision it, might come to a near standstill for long periods of time. Life on Earth has proven resilient to cold periods. For example, there are species that can completely dry out, freeze, and then effectively come back to life when conditions allow for it. Essentially, this isn't just dormancy, but a period of death and resurrection, and it's not just simple life, there are species of frog that can do this. As to what's possible elsewhere in the universe, there may even be intelligent species that have evolved in harsher conditions than Earth that hibernate, or even outright die in order to survive periods of adverse conditions, only to rehydrate when times get better and effectively come back to life. Such a species might even use that to their advantage, making long journeys across space in a state of natural suspended animation, or even temporary death. Number 4. Silicon-based life. Most elements on the periodic table are not good candidates for life due to their chemistry. An element like gold, for example, doesn't have the ability to react with other elements to create the complex chemistry needed to sustain an analog of biology. But there are a few that might, and chief among these is silicon. Silicon is in the same group as carbon on the periodic table and can form complex molecules that could conceivably be a basis for life. But it's much more limited than carbon is. But on the other hand, it's been suggested that silicones could be more stable than hydrocarbons in atmospheres rich in sulfuric acid, such as Venus-like worlds. And while carbon is extremely common in the universe, more so than silicon, terrestrial planets like Earth are very rich in silicon, yet poorer in carbon. Yet, despite that, life on Earth is carbon-based, and we have not found any strictly silicon-based life on this world, though plenty of life uses it, such as diatoms. And one hypothesis holds that the presence of silicon may have been necessary for carbon-based life to have its genesis. Silicon-based life might also be well adapted for very low temperatures, or high ones. And it has to be said that it may be the case that silicon ends up being the basis for intelligent life, not in a biological context, but a technological one, as a species may choose to transition to become a machine civilization. But silicon isn't the only possibility. Boron-based life is also in principle thought possible, though it's somewhat rare in the universe. Sulfur also has hypothetical scenarios where life based on it might be possible, but perhaps most interestingly are some of the metals. Life might also, under very strict conditions, exist using metal oxidation, even at very high temperatures where carbon-based life probably cannot exist. Number 3. Neutron star life. One of the biggest problems when discussing the possibilities of alien life are biases. Carl Sagan once said that he was a carbon chauvinist, and to a degree a water chauvinist when speculating about what alien life could be like. But it could also be surprising, and nothing like what we're used to. One possibility, though a long shot, would be life based on a neutron star. First proposed by Frank Drake and explored in the books of Robert Forward, this highly speculative form of life would exist on the surface of a neutron star. They would be very tiny, submicroscopic, existing based on a kind of alternate type of molecule where tightly packed atomic nuclei form random molecules of sorts. It's a complete unknown if this is even possible. Neutron stars are made up of extraordinarily dense material. But what can be said is that if this type of life does indeed exist, it might exist in fast forward due to the speed at which nuclear reactions occur. they would experience their lives conceivably millions of times faster than you do. Number 2, plasma life. So far, we've taken the subject of alternative life mostly from the standpoint of straightforward chemistry, but that may not be the only possibility for life. In 2003, researchers were able to create plasmas that exhibited lifelike behavior, in that they could grow, replicate, and even communicate to some degree with each other. This plasma phenomenon featured a distinct layer, much like a cell wall, that separated it from its outside environment, a key feature of biological cells. They could also replicate by splitting in two, again like living cells, and they demonstrated the ability to grow under certain circumstances. The communication came in the form of electromagnetic emissions. If this indeed can be considered a form of life, which is fully open for debate, we may have already seen an alternative form of life. Number 1, the shadow biosphere and RNA life. While speculative, the concept of panspermia, the idea that life could hitch a ride on rocks, blast it off a planet, and then fall on another planet and survive it to colonize, isn't all that far-fetched and may well have occurred within our own solar system. Indeed, life on Earth might have originally been seeded here from some other body, such as Mars, where conditions in the past may have made it an easier place for life to arise than Earth was at the time. But the idea of panspermia can be extended to interstellar scales. While carbon-based life as we know it may not have the greatest chances of surviving interstellar travel, it's possible that some of the hypothetical alternative life on this list might fare better, such as silicon-based life. If this is indeed possible, it might be here undetected, or if silicon-based simple indigenous life could have formed on Earth, then would we even know about it? The answer is not necessarily. The shadow biosphere is a hypothesized second biosphere, or even a second separate genesis of life on Earth, based on some other biochemistry. Given that our methods of studying microbial life typically depend in some way on familiar means of biochemistry, it's possible that an entirely different microbial world could, at least in principle, exist alongside our standard microbial biosphere undetected. Another variant on this theme is that it's possible that there were once organisms on Earth that may have been based on RNA instead of DNA. If so, the methods typically used to detect microorganisms wouldn't detect them. Should they still be living among us? While the shadow biosphere is hypothetical, there is a phenomenon in geology known as desert varnish that's not well understood. It forms as deposits on the surface of rocks, and its origin is more likely to be geological rather than biological. But one odd feature of this material is that it's very high in manganese, about 50 times more abundant than is normal for Earth's crust. One possibility that's been advanced is that a shadow microorganism could be depositing it. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing my office suspiciously, wondering if there's a shadow biosphere in here, and what it's currently doing. It's all very cloak and dagger, the microbial world, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer, and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.